1981 McGarry Medal Telecast is brought to you by Hallett Brick Industries, Kenmax Electrical Discounts, Tweed's Menswear, and the Mazda dealers of South Australia.
Hello everyone, it's a big night for South Australian football with the count and presentation of the 1981 McGarry Medal, our football's top individual award. Our host, of course, Ken Cunningham. All set for a big night, Ken?
Certainly is, Rob. Just looking around the ballroom here at the Old Lion Hotel, it's a wonderful sight. Plenty of enthusiasm, plenty of speculation as to who will win the most prestigious award in South Australian football. I think it's great to see the ladies here for the first time. Of course, we see Diane Ebert, the wife of Russell Ebert, who's won, what, 4 McGarry Medals. And of course, the big question being asked, can he win his 5th McGarry Medal? Then we see the lovely wife of the Norwood coach, Nilbaum Jean. She's here tonight looking very, very gorgeous in a beautiful dress there. So all is set for what appears to be and what is going to be a very, very exciting McGarry Medal count, that's for sure.
Well, for weeks now, we of the media and you at home no doubt have been talking about who you think are the strongest possibilities to win the McGarry Medal tonight. Well, Ken, there's a short list of very strong possibilities and a much longer list of the long shots.
Well, certainly is, Rob. You can go through most sides and say, well, he's got a chance to win the medal. We look at players like Kevin McSporran, who's had a tremendous season for West Torrens. Eddie Fry, whether it's centre-half back or centre-half forward for Sturt, had a great year. Richard Hamilton in the middle for West Adelaide. No one can doubt his ability. So we can go right through the list. Bobby Enright, of course, the back pocket player for West Torrens, also has had a wonderful year. Bomber Clifford
and Paul Belton.
So,
also,
you know, we can go right through and name players who have a distinct possibility of winning the McGarry Medal.
Right. What about the strong possibilities, though?
What we've done, Rob, we've picked out 10 players who we believe can, in fact, win the 1981 McGarry Medal. Let's now see those players in action.
Mention the 1981 McGarry Medal, most people will say it's Michael Aisher's. Aisher's determined, dedicated, dynamic, and he does everything with a touch of class. The name on most football fans' lips is Michael Aisher. Russell Ebert made history by winning his 4th McGarry Medal last year, but he feels that this season's been as good as, if not better, than 1980. Now, could we see a 5th medal go to the Port Adelaide champion tonight? Sturt centre man Neil Craig is high in the calculations. He's strong, creative, and a superb team man. Most importantly, he's had a tremendously consistent season. This year, he's fulfilled all expectations. Peter Carey's a giant of South Australian football in more ways than one, but incredibly, it's been 30 years since a ruckman won the medal. Can Carey break the drought, or will he share the disappointment of Peter Daly and Rick Davies? Tiger captain, the versatile Paul Weston's one of the few players who can change the course of a game midstream. Weston's a complete professional on the field. He does everything that has to be done, then just a little bit more. 1981 seen a vintage crop of new players burst on the scene. South Rover Mark Nody's one youngster who's matured into a match winner. With quick reactions and tremendous acceleration, Nody's a new force in South Australian football. Rob Hawkins is another ruckman who could poll well tonight. The big-hearted Hawkins has carried the South Rucks this season, putting in an outstanding solo effort. With Terry Moore back with the Dogs, Peter Byfield was able to concentrate more on his general field play, becoming a valuable ruckman come forward and kicking over 30 goals for the season. John Platten is fast, agile and clever with the ball. He's made a sensational start to his league career. But can a first-year player win the medal? Dan Moriarty did it in different circumstances in 1919, and Platten certainly is something special. The 1981 season's biggest improver is undoubtedly North Adelaide's David Tiller. Given a run of the ball and the freedom of the forward lines, Tiller's come into his own. He's been consistent and persistent. Tiller just doesn't know how to give up.
Rob, who's your choice?
I'm going for an each-way bet, Ken. Either Russell Ebert to win his 5th,
right,
or that curly-headed, skinny guy with the red socks on Michael Aisher. I think it'd be a worthy medalist.
I certainly agree with you there, Rob, but I'll go for Neil Craig, the Sturt centreman. I think he's had a tremendous year, and he's certainly the type of player that attracts the attention of the umpire. Anyway, we'll take this short commercial break and join our 260 invited guests at the 1981 McGarry Medal presentation. welcome back to the 1981 McGarry Medal presentation. This time I would like to extend a very warm welcome to the ladies here this evening. I must confess, looking around the ballroom tonight, it certainly gives the presentation a great deal of colour. Ladies, welcome and have a wonderful time. South Australia is renowned for its ability to produce some of the top youngsters in Australian football. Our performances in the Till Cup of recent years have proven that, winning three of the past four championships. Tonight, we would like to honour a member of this year's Till Cup, and in fact, the winner of the Under-17s McCullum Medal from Norwood, Gary McIntosh.
Was a clear-cut winner, polling 35 votes, 18 clear of his nearest rival. He joined Norwood from the Hope Valley Football Club in 1979. This year he captained the Redlegs Under-17s and he played in the State Till Cup team. Gary's played 39 League Under-17 games and he's an apprentice diesel mechanic by trade. Winner of the 1981 McCullum Medal, Gary McIntosh of Norwood.
Gary, congratulations. And before the medal count, did you give yourself any chance of winning the medal?
No, not much of a chance. There's a lot of good players this year, but not for me.
They tell me you're nervous now. Don't be nervous, you'll make me nervous. Yeah. Gary, just tell me something about your career. When did you first start with Norwood?
About 1977.
With the under 15s.
Yeah, special talent squad.
Right, and you've gone through the grades there.
Yeah.
And just looking at your career so far, who do you believe has given you the most support in your career?
Mum and Dad, sure. And first of all at Hope Valley, I had Brian Vaughan and Stan McHugh.
Right.
And this year, Ian Stafford, I've had him for 3 years. He's been a great coach. And Johnny Winsaid a lot this year.
Fantastic. Now, of course, you remember this year's Till Cup, which played at Vairfield Park and played in front of 93,000 people. What was the feeling like for a youngster like yourself? How did you feel?
Oh, well, you didn't notice it during the game, but after a while, when you turned around and looked around, it was just unreal.
Disappointing not to win from South Australia's point of view?
Yeah, for sure.
Leading up until half-time, what happened in the second half?
Ran out of legs.
Ran out of legs. I believe you played in the back pocket in that particular game. Now, you normally play centre and so forth. How did you enjoy that?
Oh, I love it, Billy.
Right. And your ambition in football?
Play league football for North.
Who's the footballer you admire most?
Michael Ashe.
Michael Ashe. Is he your tip for the medal?
Yep, no worries.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Under-17s McCullum Medal from Norwood, Gary McIntosh. Well, it certainly has been a big year in the junior ranks for Norwood, as was the case last year, because they also supplied the winner of the Under-19 Tompkins Medal from Norwood, their captain, Dean Renfrey.
Captain of the Norwood Under-19s. He started with the club's special squads in Under-13s, 14s and 15s. He played 29 games with the Under-17s in 1977 and 78 and has played 59 with the Under-19s since 1979. He also played Till Cup football and was in the state high school Under-16 team. Dean's an apprentice mechanic with the railways. Norwood's Dean Renfrey, the winner of the 1981 Tompkins Medal.
Dean, congratulations, and how did you feel when you first heard the news of your medal win?
Didn't believe it at first. I was quite shocked, actually.
Who broke the news to you?
Glenn McCullum, our
right.
Director.
Now, I believe you've played a number of positions this year for the Norwood side. Which one do you prefer?
I've played Ruck Rover, centre, and I've also roved this year.
Right.
I prefer Ruck Rover and centre, yeah.
Right. Now, who's had the most influence on your career so far?
Malcolm Smith, our coach this year. I've been under him 3 years and he's taught me a lot about football and a lot about growing up with the game.
Right, now tell me what happened last Saturday in the second semi-final.
Not a great deal. we had a lot of troubles and Gary said earlier, we ran out of legs and centrals were too good for us on the day.
Right, now what about this coming weekend against Port Adelaide?
Well, we've starting a new look towards it and for the week after when we do win after Saturday. Yes.
And who's the footballer you most admire?
Careful.
Yeah, I've got to be careful. Russell Ebert would be the footballer I'm most...
Coming from a Norwood player, Russell Ebert.
Michael Taylor, him too, he's a champion too, and Michael Ashe.
Right, now, who's your choice for the medal?
Michael Ashe.
Michael Ashe. Well, Dean, good luck on Saturday. Let's hope you can win the prelim final, and let's hope this is a step so far as your career is concerned. Well done. Thanks, ladies and gentlemen, Dean Renfrey. For the second year in a row, it's been a West Adelaide player who has won the League Reserves McGarry Medal, the boy from Renmark, Bruce Lindner.
Bruce is 20. He polled 30 votes to win the medal by 1 point from the Tigers' Tony Simons. Bruce polled 6 first, 5 second, and 2 third preference votes in the 11 reserves games he played. A superb ball handler, he's also played 10 league games this year. The League Reserves McGarry medalist, West Adelaide's Bruce Lindner.
Bruce, that's a magnificent performance, only playing, what, 11 reserves game to win the McGarry medal. Were you surprised?
Oh, most definitely. I really had no idea that I...
That's not what Doug Thomas told me.
Yeah, Doug says a lot. No, I really had no idea that I would poll so well. I was out on the town, I think I went to the Royal Show and got back and Mum said a few words. I was really pleased, I was.
Right, now Bruce, you're from Renmark. When did you join West Adelaide?
I think it was, I'd have to have a guess, 79, 78 season. Coming from Renmark, played a few A-grade games down there. I think, yeah, it was the 79 season. And played a few under-19s and reserves games.
Always been a West Adelaide supporter?
Oh, not really. It's not pretty really. Hard when you've got conflict from uncles and so forth in the North Adelaide club.
North Adelaide camp.
Yeah.
Now, what about Saturday? Disappointed? Your first major round? How did you feel?
I was quite sort of excited going out there and playing in front of the finals, in the finals round. The first half was very good, I thought. A few bad decisions in the second half, but...
Shh, the umpires are listening.
No, really, I enjoyed it immensely, I really did.
Right, now your ambition, Bruce, how far as footy is concerned?
Well, at the moment, to get a berth permanently in the West Adelaide side, and possibly go on from there.
The premiership side. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Reserves McGarry Medal, Bruce Lindner.
Thank you.
We have just had the pleasure of meeting three of our future champions in South Australia. No doubt there'll be many more following in their footsteps. We are the champions, my friends. And we'll keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions. We are the champions. At this point, I'd like to welcome viewers in the Loxton and Port Perry areas to our presentation this evening. The third preference votes, carrying 1 point, have already been fed into our Wang computer. Let's look at the voting of the top nine from each club. First of all, Central Districts. Johnny Platten on top with 5. We have 2 players on 4, Van Dommel and Gillies. Have a number of players on 2, Philip Graham, Bytheen, Edwards and Boehm, and on 1 point, Livesey and Wright. So Johnny Platten there on top so far as Centrals are concerned. Moving along to the Tigers, the top nine there, so far as the voting is concerned, Ralph Sewer and Peter Carey on 4, 2 players on 3, Captain Paul Weston and David Marshall, Philly Phyllis on 2, and then 4 players each polling 1 point. Kernahan, 12-3, McDermott and Jimmy LaHue. From the Roosters' point of view, voting there, the top nine, Clisby on 3 points, Greg Schlein 2, likewise David Tiller, a number of players on 1, Entrebus, Stringer, Riley, Loken, Curley and Wayne Stringer. From the Red Legs, after the counting of the first preference votes, Michael Ace, one of the favourites for this year's medal, on top with 6, Danny Jenkins 5, two players on 3, Stemper and Philip Gallagher. Likewise, two players on 2, Juliano and Button, Teal, Fosdyke and Greg Turbill all on 1. From the Magpies, again, one of the favourites for the medal, Russell Ebert on 4, Bomber Clifford, or should I say Ebert on 6, Bomber Clifford on 4, Abernethy 3, Greg Phillips 2, a number of players on 1, including Paul Belton, Tony Martin, Brad Moore, Russell Johnson, and Kim Kinnear. South Adelaide, the Panthers. Naylor with 6, Hawkins 4, White 3, Graham Brooksby and Slattery on 2, then 4 players on 1, Linky, Palmer, Phil Brooksby and Dawkins. Turning now to the Double Blues. See who's the top pollster there after counting of the third preferences. Neil Craig on 3, a number of players on 2, Leonard, McGarry, Phil Heinrich, Zubinich, Michael Graham and Wilson, and 1 point Dolan and Friedrichs. To West Adelaide, the voting there, Jeff Morris, the All-Australian half-forward flanker, with 7, Cantaleptis 4, Borchardt 3, then 2 players on 2, Ray Hayes and Peter Murette, 4 players on 1, Lindner, Watson, Kennedy and Richard Hamilton. To the Eagles, McSparren, Enright and Hannah, all polling 3, Robson, Hill, Thomas and Hank, all polling 1. And finally to the Peckers, looking now as to who will be the top pollster after counting of the third preference votes. For the Woodville side, Mansfield and McLeod each 4, Parker and Huppert's 3, a number of players on 1, Heaven, Beecroft, Dowsett, Lennon and Richards. That's the overall 9 from each individual club. Let's now have a look at the overall 9 after the counting of the third preference votes, and certainly it will be a very, very interesting situation. And there it is. We find Jeff Morris with 7 points on top of West Adelaide in front of Mark Nolley of South Adelaide, also Michael Ashe, Russell Ebert on 6, Platten and Jenkins on 5, Clifford, Mansfield and McLeod each polling 4 points. So the leader at the moment on 7 points from West Adelaide, Peter Marker, talks to that gentleman.
Jeffrey Morris, traditionally not a good place to be on top at the end of the third preferences.
No, I'm sure all my votes are there now.
Well, you never know, Jeff. I think there have been a couple that have got up from this position. Jeff, the broken arm, obviously it was a great disappointment to you with West Adelaide playing in the finals this year. I'm sure you would have loved to have been out there.
Oh, it would have been beautiful to play Saturday. It was just bad luck. We couldn't go on with it.
You could have matched a bit of physical strength with the Barmy, perhaps.
Oh, I'm glad he's sitting over there.
You've got your lovely fiancée, Lorraine, with you tonight. With your permission, I might ask Lorraine a question. Is that all right?
Go ahead.
Lorraine, with Jeff's broken arm, are you making life comfortable for him, are you?
Oh, yeah. Tying your shoes every morning.
See, that's good. They don't say much, do they, Jeff? Well, Jeff, you're in front at the moment with 7 votes. Let's hope you can keep polling and look after that broken arm, and we hope to see you back with West Adelaide for a full season next year.
Okay, thank you, Peter.
There have been many notable events and achievements recognised in 1981. These don't happen without a great deal of sacrifice, dedication and a true love for the sport of Australian football. It's not only a matter of hours or years, but in some cases it's almost a lifetime.
Master coach Jack Otis capped an incredible career by being the first person outside of league officialdom to receive league life membership. After 36 years of football, he holds the Australian record for the number of seasons, the number of games, and the number of times he's coached a team in the finals. And of course, there are those 10 premierships. Four of his protégés, Neil Curley, Darrell Hicks, John Halbert, and Mike Noonan, coach league sides this year. As well as being father to Mark, Anthony, Jenny and Stephen, Foss Williams has made a tremendous contribution to South Australian football over the past 30 years. This year, he was awarded League Life membership, and he was also honoured with the institution of the F.N. Williams Medal. The winner of the inaugural Foss Williams Medal was the Glenelg ruckman Peter Carey. Carey was South Australia's best player in the interstate match against Western Australia. Port Adelaide's powerhouse full forward Tim Evans has become the first Magpie player to kick more than 500 goals. And this season, he took out the first ever Ken Farmer medal for kicking the most goals in the minor round. Four times McGarry medalist Russell Ebert, with 295 games for Port, 25 for North Melbourne and 20 for South Australia, has become the first Port Adelaide player to play over 300 games. On the 6th of June, Graham Corns made his 276th league appearance for Glenelg, and that broke Fred Phillis's long-standing club record. Roger Woodcock kicked his 600th goal in league football on the 29th of August. He's our highest ever non-specialist full forward goal scorer, and he's the sixth highest goal kicker in South Australian league history, behind Ken Farmer, Fred Phillis, Jack Owens, Bruce Schultz and Malcolm Greenslade. And this season saw Sturt's Mr. Magic, Paul Bagshaw, announce his retirement after a record 360 league games over 17 seasons. He represented the state 14 times. The former Sturt captain was five times club best and fairest winner, was awarded an MBE in 1979 for his services to football. He's regarded by many as the finest player not to win a McGarry medal.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Magic, Paul Bagshaw. Certainly a wonderful career. And no doubt some wonderful achievements here by some great names in Australian football. And there wouldn't be a football season without criticism of the men in white. We mustn't forget them. But being men of strong character, as I've said many, many times in the past, they certainly take it on the chin. Whether you like it or not, they select our McGarry medalists. Now the boys walking into the room, doing the all-important job of casting their votes for the McGarry medal. Not an easy job, but certainly a very important part of their duty. And of course, let's now talk to one of the senior umpires and one of the up-and-coming umpires so far as football is concerned. Ladies and gentlemen, John Hilton. And there's Johnny Hilton talking to Graham Dunstan, the Norwood footballer, taking control, as most umpires do, exchanging a few pleasantries, setting the pattern for the game. One of those good things about umpiring. And Graham Dunstan, of course, expressing his views on the matter as well. Johnny Hilton, what did you say to Graham Dunstan?
I can't remember.
What did he say to you?
I can't remember that either.
Johnny, going back to the start, how did you get involved in the occupation of umpiring?
I guess it goes back about 14 years, Ken, and I remember a good friend of mine who was umpiring at the stage with the league, umpiring schoolboys, and he was approached by South Adelaide Football Club to come over and umpire their schoolboys' games.
Right.
And he was asked, do you know anybody that's keen to take it on? And he approached me, so out I went, and that's where I started, and who I started with.
Unfortunately for you, yes, with me. You've umpired 60 league games, Johnny. Which has been the most pleasing moment for you throughout that career?
The
difficult
most,
question?
Yeah, no, not really. The one that gave me the greatest thrill would have to be my first league final.
Right. What about the vocal part from the crowd? Does that worry you at all, being an umpire?
The only thing that worries me about it is there's not enough of it in South Australia.
The louder they roar, the better you umpire.
Oh, look, that creates the atmosphere, not only for us, but I think for the players as well. And I think we saw that back in 79 with the chanting of Centrals, when the supporters of Centrals, when Centrals were really going, and that spurred them on. And I think the crowd participation is what we really lack here.
Johnny, just looking at umpiring, has it given you a different outlook on life generally, being out there controlling 36 players and so forth?
Yeah, I guess after a while, you tend to be a little bit more tolerant towards people and patient with people. You must remember that everybody's created equal, but we've all got different personalities, and there's something that, or a little thing that Laurie Argent lives by, and I never forget hearing him say it, and that is, you treat everybody equally, but you treat everybody differently.
Right.
And I think there's merit in that.
Fair point. Just going back to your school days, I believe one of your teachers, or in fact your teacher, was the Glenel coach, John Howard.
Yes, he was, yes.
How do you find him now?
He's a good bloke.
What was he like as a teacher?
John had his little traits. In the football season, if you had to be disciplined in class, you wore a number 9.5 up the backside. In cricket season, if you need to be disciplined, you got a cover drive, because he played cricket as well.
Now, Johnny, what about your ambitions?
Well, I think anybody involved, when we're talking football, their ambition would have to be to participate in a grand final. I think whichever grade that you're involved in, whether you be official or a spectator, player, umpire, whatever grade you're involved in, your ambition should be to participate in a grand final, and that would be the ultimate as far as I'm concerned.
Well, Johnny, good luck on that quest. Let's hope that it's not too far away, and you've done tremendously well so far. Let's hope it continues for you. Ladies and gentlemen, one of our leading umpires, John Hilton. We'll come back with more from the 1981 McGee Medal televised. Welcome back to the 1981 McGee Medal presentation. The third and second preference votes have been fed into the Wang computer. Let's look at the top nine, firstly from the Bulldogs. There's the top nine after the second preference votes have been counted. Gillies on top with 12, Platten 9, two players on 7, Wright and Moore, three players on 6, Peter Bytheen, Boehm and Van Dommel, and two players on 4, Craig and Philip Graham. No doubt, of course, one of the strong contenders from the Bulldog camp is their 18-year-old sensational rover, Johnny Platten.
Puts a long one in towards the goals. Bull Platten's down there. Great mark! Oh, what a mark!
Gillies fires away towards goal, right up towards full forward. The spoil is on. Platten reads it well off the back of the back. Fires towards goal and set another goal.
Here, snared by Gillies, however. A hurry kick by Gillies is over the head of Lahou. An awkward bounce. Platten's there. Wilson, Platten the ground. Wilson support. Platten the goal! Oh, great play, Johnny Platten.
Darrell, of course, in 1979, when you coached Central Districts, John Duckworth won the medal. Do you think that had an adverse effect on your preparations for the finals that year?
Well, it had a great effect upon John. As experienced as he may have been from playing in Western Australia, Victoria and South Australia, it really did affect him. And I think perhaps there's only one person here tonight that could win the medal and still play well next Sunday.
Who's that?
That's Russell.
Oh, I see. Yes, well, he's won enough, hasn't he? Well, almost. Perhaps he might win one more. Gee, Tony Pilkington's cigar's fairly hard to take, isn't it? He's sitting right under my chin. You're very good with your mind games with your players, Darrell, and the most famous one is the black and white matches, of course, before the Port Adelaide match. What would you prescribe for, say, John Halbert this week prior to the match with Port Adelaide?
Well, I don't really prescribe any gimmicks, as they are sometimes called. But I did learn that trick from Foss Williams. Remember that he had the white patches on the black shorts when I was a boy. And so, but the aim of the exercise really is to help the player to concentrate his mind on the task. It worked for Lindsay Head with the wooden spoons, and it seems to have worked for me. But obviously, John Halbert and John Cale will be using other more realistic methods to get their players to concentrate on the task in hand. No gimmicks will be required next Sunday.
I'm sure you're right, Darrell. Just very quickly, have you got a tip for tonight?
Yes, you can only go on the games that you've seen, and I think Eddie Fry from Sturt would be the most outstanding player that we have seen against us this year, and I think that he has all the traits of a McGarry Medal contender, and he plays brilliantly, and I believe he polled very well last year. So my tip is Eddie Fry.
Wish you were an umpire. Thanks, Darrell.
Peter Marker talking there to Central's coach, Darrell Hicks. Let's now have a look at the voting so far as the top nine for the Tigers are concerned. On top, we have their captain, Paul Weston, with 13, two players on 10, Carey and Sewer, Rady on 8, and then three players on 4, Vady, Painter and Seabohm, and two players on 3, Marshall and Keith Coolman. Well, certainly Paul Weston, their captain, once again has had a tremendous season.
Seabohm sorts out his skipper, and Weston has the luxury of a bounce, strides to the centre line and passes the ball beautifully to McDermott at centre half forward. In turn, he's got 12th tree clear, and that's the way the ball will go. Breaks around on the left foot, gives it back to Weston. What's the bird backing up from Weston? Oh, he ran 150 metres to get to that ball. Dunstan can't get clear. Corns again over to Weston. And a quiet run is Paul, but he's bouncing his way forward now. He's going to try for one that he had last week. He kicked three. He's done it! Oh, what a goal! Oh, what a goal for Weston!
John Halbert, you won the medal, of course, in 1961, and gee, that was 20 years ago, wasn't it?
Do you have to remind me it's that long, Peter?
Well, I was still at primary school at the time, but I can remember...
I didn't think you were born then.
No, I can remember you as a player, John, and you were a very good one, obviously, to have won the medal, and I think you were a runner-up three times before winning it. But one thing that surprises me is that the Sturt Football Club hasn't won a McGarry medal since that time. Do you think it's difficult for champion clubs to produce McGarry medalists?
Well, not really, Peter. I think Russell Ebert is the obvious reply to that. He's won four, and... Port Adelaide have been very successful in that era, and Kimmy Hodgman...
You don't know something, do you?
No, I don't think... not the night, anyway. And Kimmy Hodgman won one in 78 when Glenelg were a strong side, so I don't really believe that it has to be that way. Why Sturt haven't won one is a mystery to me.
John, you've seen a lot of champion footballers in your time. What about the champions that haven't won medals, in your opinion?
Well, there are a lot of great players who have never won medals, and it's always a mystery. You know, I look at a person like John Kay, who was a great player in his day and was never successful in winning a medal. And Paul Bagshaw at Sturt, who is a great player, and Rick Davies more recently there. And I've got a few at this table with me now who haven't won one yet, and it surprises me to some degree that they haven't.
I didn't think you had such a high opinion on me, John.
I didn't actually look to my left then, did I, Peter? I'm sorry if I did. But, yeah, it is. It's always amazing that happens, but I guess it's the way the umpires see it, and that's the way it has to be.
Thanks very much for talking to us, John.
Pleasure, Peter.
Thank you, Peter Marker. Let's now have a look at the voting for the top nine for North Adelaide. Clisby on top with 9, David Tiller with 8, Bill Loken with 7, Redden 6, then 2 players on 4, Greg Sline and Greg McAdam, Riley with 3, and then 2 players on 2, Allgate and Rodney Robram. Turning now to the Redlegs, top 9, so far as their voting is concerned, and we find Michael Aish with 26 votes at the moment. One of the favourites for the medal, 26 to Michael Aish, Danny Jenkins and Turville on 9, 3 players on 5, Andrew Aish, Thomas and Stemper, and also Teal, Gallagher and Button on 4. Well, certainly, Michael Aish has had a wonderful year. Can he win his first McGarry medal?
Down they go, over the top by Aish. Brilliant football. Giuliano was grabbed around the leg, but good umpiring lets it go on. Michael Aish! From behind it was Jenkins, Dillon for the crumbs. Oh, a beautiful tackle. Here's a chance to Michael Aish. He's got plenty of time. Steadies in towards an open goal. We'll wait on the umpire. Up high goes Colville. No worries. Straight to the middle.
Teal the front. From behind Grambo Aish. Geez, clever. Thump further afield by the Eagles. Hannah loses it. Chance for Norwood now. Michael Aish. Oh, he's done it. I can't believe it. And the Norwood supporters go berserk. A great goal, and who should do it better than Michael Aish, because he's won the game for Norwood.
Well, he certainly had a wonderful year, and there he is, Michael Aish, at the moment with 26 points. Turning now to Port Adelaide, the top pollster so far as the Magpies are concerned, we find Bucky Cunningham on top with 11, Ebert 10, Abernethy 9, Clifford on 8, and 3 players on 7, Belton, Johnston and Kinnear, Bradmore on 3, and Greg Phillips on 2. Can Russell Ebert win his 5th McGarry medal?
Intercepted beautifully by Ebert. 50 metres out. Pops it goal. What a magnificent goal, Russell Ebert.
Hargraves at half back towards centre wing. From behind it, Simmons, but there's a fine mark in front. And who else? Russell Ebert.
Needs support. Has it now. The ball screwed back over the shoulder by Harrison in towards centre half forward. Popping. Oh, but a great mark again by Russell. to leave it in pursuit McDermott, but Cole's got a 10 metre break on him, kicks it back towards centre half forward. Oh, Ebert, what a mark, beautiful mark by Russell Ebert.
Russell, it's that time of the year again.
Yes, it's come around again, another year.
It's just changed a bit, hasn't it, when you look around. About 10 years ago when you first won it, it was a couple of crates of beer out the back.
Yes, it was sort of down in Centennial Hall, and we were sitting home in the lounge listening to it on the wireless, and got fairly excited then, and then shot into the hall. But it's all changed now, and everyone's getting their slice out of it, I think.
I think it was a good suggestion of yours last year, Russ.
Yeah, so do I. I think it's a bit of colour.
Russell, you won your first 10 years ago, and I think one thing that that amazes me is that here we are 10 years later, you're one of the favoured players again. And you're still playing extremely well. How do you keep the enthusiasm up?
Well, I enjoy the participation and the team game, and encouraged by the family, and I just enjoy competing, and love to get out there and play, and I'll keep doing that as long as I keep enthusiastic.
Hope you can do it for a few more years, Russell. Good to talk to you, and best of luck with the count tonight.
Thanks, Pete.
And you too, Russell Lee. Turning now to the Panthers and looking at their top nine so far as the voting is concerned from South Adelaide. Certainly be very interesting. Hawkins on 14, Naylor on 12, White on 9, Slattery 8, Sneebicker on 7, two players on 6, Graham Brooksby and Fairclough, and likewise two players on 4, Harradine and also Allen. Turning now to the Double Blues. Of course, one of their favourites is Neil Craig. We find two players on 11 points, Friedrichs and Neil Craig on 11, Graham on 8, a number of players on 4, Sims, Casey, Phil Heinrich and McGarry, and two players on 3, Hollis and Derrington. Well, Neil Craig undoubtedly has had one of his best years in the centre for the Double Blues.
It is Klomp's kick. Craig up high, great mark.
Lee Fry's got margarine on the fingers, went through his hands. Ball at centre field. Oh, brilliant mark taken by Craig. Plays on quickly. That's better football by the Blues.
Appeared to interfere with Carey, but the umpire not impressed. Craig took off, kicked towards goal, and that splits to centre. That's what the Blues need. The handball poorly directed. Michael Graham gets it to Howard. Howard to Craig. The Blues looking good again. Craig never misses these, and he doesn't miss that one. Craig gets his second, and the Blues have got their seventh.
Neil Craig certainly having a wonderful year, one of the top leaders there for the Sturt side. Moving along now to West Adelaide, the Wolves, top pollsters there so far as that side is concerned. Jeff Morris on 11, Borchardt their captain 9, Cantalaftis on 8, Bennett 4, a number of players on 3, Watson, Linder, Filkey, Dexter Kennedy and Richard Hamilton. To the Eagles, who will be their leader so far as the polling is concerned there, to West Torrens, their back pocket player Robbie Enright on 11, Inglis with 10, Hill and Hannah on 5, McSporran 3, and then 4 players on 2, Miller, Mano, Grambo and Peter Filippo. And here's Peter Marker talking to the coach of the Eagles and Triple McGarry medalist, Lindsay Head.
Lindsay, I noticed a bit of grey hair up there. Is that it looks very distinguished, it really does. But is that what happens when you become a lead coach?
I'm not the only one. I was watching Jack Halbert. He's got a few grey ones amongst the the bald top there. But even KG's got a few. So no, I guess we've had our worrying times this year, and I've got a lot greyer this year than I was before I started.
You coached West Torrens back in 1959 and 1960 as captain coach, and on both occasions you ended up just out of the four. What's different now to then?
Well, the difference is we were a lot closer then than we were this year. But
I go along with that. Yeah.
I guess the demands on the players, coaches, officials are much greater this year, and also the demands on physical fitness and running and pace are very, very much greater than they were in those days.
Lindsay, you've won 3 medals. You must know what it takes to win a McGarry medal. Who, in your opinion, is going to win it tonight?
Well, you know, Russell's a great player, but, you know, I saw one of the greatest young players I've ever seen on Saturday in Michael Ashe, and, you know, he is one of the most balanced players that I've ever seen, and I think that, although at this stage with 26 points it doesn't look real good, he deserves to win a medal because he's a very, very fine player.
Well, he's going to be playing for a few more years anyway, isn't he?
Well, he'll get his chance later on, but, you know, there's no time like the present. You know, we thought Peter Daly years ago would get a chance to win a medal, a great player, but it didn't ever come. And footballers are day-to-day propositions. You don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. And, you know, I'd surely think Michael would think, well, let's get one now if I can.
I reckon. Thank you very much for your comments, Lindsay.
Thanks, Peter.
Well, let's hope someone, 1982 was a better year for West Torrens. Turning now to Woodville, the top pollster so far as they are concerned for the Packers. We can get the voting there for the Woodville side. On top, we find two players in Parker and Heaven with five, Mansfield and McLeod with four, a number of players on three, Beecroft, Huppets, Dowsett and also Lennon and McCormick on 2 points there. Of course, now we come to the all-important part, the overall leaders. So far as the voting is concerned, getting to a very, very interesting stage. Let's now have a look at the top nine so far as the voting is concerned. We see Michael Ace from Norwood on top with 26 points. In second position, Rob Hawkins on 14 from South Adelaide, Western 13 from the Tigers, two players on 12, Mark Naley and Jeff Gillies, a number of players on 11, Enright, Friedrichs, Morris and Bucky Cunningham. That's the voting so far, and in a moment we'll talk to one of the true champions of Australian football. Let's now talk to a gentleman who won the McGarry Medal back in 1972, won the Brownlow in 1978, the first South Australian player to do that since Bernie Smith in 1951, a true champion of Australian football. Ladies and gentlemen, make welcome Malcolm Blight.
Melbourne, 35 metres out from goal, has a hurried shot toward goal, and I think he's pumped it through. He has.
A half forward line grabbed by Blight. He's caught. Play on, said the umpire. Onto the left foot goes Malcolm Blight. He snaps at the goals. Is it true? Yes. By Hodgman towards Blight. Can he trap it? Goes in after it. Still got it. Blight runs around into the open goal. Fires it back at the goals. Is it true? It is. For Spencer as he gives it out to his teammate there in Reeves. Over to Blight. A chance for Blight. He snaps around. He hooks at the goals. Is it true? Yes.
Still possession. A chip now to Blight. He's kicked six. Here's number seven.
Malcolm, that particular day, 11 goals, six, five out of bounds on the full. Not a bad performance.
Yes, I kicked poorly, actually. No, it was good. It was after a lot of turmoil the week before, so it was the first time that I played full forward all year for the whole game. So, and the ball came down fairly often, so you get a lot of chances when the ball does come down often.
Malcolm, it's great to have you home. The obvious question, are you going to stay?
Tonight, yes.
Not permanently?
No, I've got a couple of years to go at North Melbourne, hopefully, if the body can stand it. And then from then on, we'll just see what happens from there on in.
Right, now the decision to resign as the coach of North Melbourne, first of all, that must have been a very difficult decision, and secondly, why did you do it?
Yes, you know, much has been said about it, and I've probably said some things of late. I didn't say anything at the time, but it was really a question of, in coaching a league side, of which there's a number in the room tonight, being first time at it, North Melbourne weren't successful. We'd missed the five with six games to go. And so when I went home and looked in the mirror, I just said to myself, well, am I the one causing that? And perhaps I may have been. Perhaps I may have learned something with the 9 months. But also, I do know there are a lot of players at North Melbourne that certainly didn't look themselves in the mirror. I early on probably misplaced a bit of trust that I'd developed over the seven previous years. And so, to cut a long story short, we weren't successful. Being responsible for on-ground performances, I really couldn't continue under the circumstances of being a playing coach. The future, what the future holds, I don't know. What the future holds for North Melbourne depends on those blokes looking in the mirror.
Well, Malcolm, going further to that, not only did you learn something about coaching, but you learned something about people, obviously.
Yes, I've certainly learned a lot, certainly in Adelaide, at Woodville, and moving to Melbourne. There's a fascinating feature of a person, that's his character. And I guess what you learn in a competitive sport is how much character we can all muster at one particular time. And looking back on finals, the season that we're in at the moment, and it really is the side that you know that goes out there that's got tremendous character and feel for what they're doing, and that's winning. When you get a feel for winning, you develop a character. That's what's got to happen for sides to get back up again.
Well, Malcolm, do you want to coach again?
Certainly can, yes. I'll somewhere along the line, if a couple of years might blot out the record of what's happened in the past 9 months, I'd like to coach again. I certainly think I'll be a better coach, only through having been through the experience. I think the technicality of coaching doesn't alter that much, certainly the way you may put it across, but the technical side of coaching's not. Perhaps in a new situation, new environment, that what I've learnt in the last 9 months may help me.
Well, after those 2 years in Melbourne, would you look at coming back to South Australia and perhaps finishing your career here?
Yeah, well, the weather's been great. It's certainly, certainly, Ken. To be quite honest, I might have done my dash at coaching in Melbourne again for the foreseeable future. So if I want to do that and I still want to play at the best level or coach at the best level possible, South Australia is certainly a possibility. Of course, then the old story, it's the demand and the supply, isn't it?
It certainly is.
You know, you need to be asked.
Well, Malcolm, football has certainly been a very big part of your life, and still is, and I know that I speak for all South Australians when we say that we are very, very proud indeed of Malcolm Blight. Ladies and gentlemen, Malcolm Blight. Thank you.
Sunday, you're bored about it. Monday, you're a sport about it. Wednesday, well, it's almost out of sight. Thursday, you talked about it. Friday, well, you're just about it. Saturday, there ain't no doubt about it. You'll be happy, you'll be surly, you'll be Western or King Curly. You'll be playing with the stars and in the wars. Cause there's a little bit of Kazali in us all. Cause there's a little bit of Kazali in us all. Some days you're devastated, some days exhilarated. Anyways, you stick through thick and thin. There are days when you squawk about it, days when you can do without it. But today's the day, you know we're gonna win it. You'll be Rocky, you'll be calm, you'll be Conzi, you'll be Bomb, you'll be playing with the stars and in the wars. Cause there's a little bit, there's a little bit, there's a little bit of Kazali in us all. Cause there's a little bit, there's a little bit, there's a little bit of Kazali in us all. There's a little bit, there's a little bit, there's a little bit of Kazali in us all. There's a little bit, there's a little bit, there's just a tiny little bit of Buckhole in us all. There's just a tiny little bit of Kazali in us all.
Welcome back to the 1981 McGarry Medal presentation. And out of the counting of the first preference votes, carrying 3 points, it's my pleasure to introduce to you the president of the South Australian National Football League, Mr. Max Bashir. Max.
Thank you, Ken. Ladies and gentlemen, the format for tonight's count will follow that of previous years. The third and second preference votes have been counted, and those results appear on the boards and are correct. The voting was suspended whilst the state team was in Perth on June the 20th, and these votes have not been counted and are in this sealed envelope. I just remind you that players who have been found guilty of a breach of the laws of the game are ineligible to win the medal. I will now proceed with the count of the first preference votes, each of which count 3 points, and I'll call the name of the club and then the name of the player. Sturt, K. Wyatt. North Adelaide, P. Cloak. West Adelaide, R. Bennett. Sturt, Keith Wyatt. West Adelaide, R. Bennett. Port Adelaide, T. Giles. Glenelg, P. Weston. Norwood, N. Button. West Torrens, R. Galt. Glenelg, P. Weston. Glenelg, P. Weston. Central District, G. Gillies. Central District, G. Gillies. Central District, D. Hart. North Adelaide, P. Cloak. South Adelaide, R. Hatley. West Torrens, K. McSporran. South Adelaide, M. Naley. Port Adelaide, B. Abernethy. Glenelg, P. Weston. Norwood, G. Nicholson. Norwood, G. Nicholson. Port Adelaide, S. Clifford. North Adelaide, D. Tiller. Central District, P. Krieg. Port Adelaide, B. Abernethy. Sturt, G. Filkey. West Adelaide, J. Cantalaftis. Glenelg, S. Copping. West Adelaide, J. Cantalaftis. That concludes the first 30 first preference votes.
Thank you, Max. Well, the count's certainly starting to warm up now. Big voting by the Glenelg captain and Paul Weston. Let's now have a look at the overall top nine after counting of the first 30 preferences. We find Michael Ace on top with 26, Weston 25, Gillies on 18, Abernethy and also Naylor on 15, two players on 14, Hawkins and Cantalaftis, and likewise two players on 11, Clifford from Port Adelaide and also Enright of West Torrens. Let's now take you back to Mr. Max Bashir for further counting of 30 votes.
South Adelaide, M. Naylor. West Adelaide, I. Borchard. Central District, P. Bythene. West Torrens, R. Galt. Norwood, Michael Aish. Norwood, K. Thomas. North Adelaide, D. Tiller. Sturt, Neil Craig. Norwood, Michael Aish. Port Adelaide, R. Ebert. Sturt, N. Craig. North Adelaide, D. Tiller. Central District, G. Gillies. West Torrens, Ian Hanna. Norwood, Phil Gallagher. Port Adelaide, P. Belton. West Adelaide, J. Cantalaftis. Glenelg, S. Copping. Glenelg, S. Copping. West Torrens, T. Hill. Norwood, G. Menzel. Norwood, D. Jenkins. Glenelg, S. Copping. West Adelaide, J. Cantalaftis. Port Adelaide, R. Johnston. Glenelg, Paul Weston. West Torrens, R. Galt. Woodville, A. Lennon. South Adelaide, Wayne Slattery. South Adelaide, R. White. That concludes the first 60 votes.
Thank you very much, Max. Let's now have a look as the momentum picks up and the enthusiasm grows larger at the overall top nine. So far as the voting in the 1981 McGee Medal is concerned, on top, Michael Ace with 32 from Norwood, Paul Weston 28 from the Tigers, Gillies on 21, Cantalathis from West Adelaide on 20, 18 is Mark Naley, two players on 17, Tiller and Craig, Abernethy on 15, and from the Tigers, Stephen Copping on 14 points. We'll come back with more counting in the 1981 McGee Medal presentation. Welcome back to the Old Lion Hotel for the counting of the first preference votes, with the leader at this stage being Michael Ace of Norwood. Back to you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Ken. Central District, P by Thien. Central District, D Hart. South Adelaide, G Brooksby. Norwood, G. Menzel. Sturt, F. Spiel. Sturt, N. Craig. South Adelaide, Mark Naley. Glenelg, D. Marshall. Glenelg, S. Copping. Sturt, M. Graham. Glenelg, D. Marshall. Port Adelaide, B. Cole. Port Adelaide, B. Cole. Norwood, P. Lachlan. Norwood, P. Lachlan. West Adelaide, I. Borchard. West Adelaide, I. Borchard. South Adelaide, M. Naley. Woodville, A. Lennon. West Adelaide, R. Hamilton. Sturt, C. Philkey. Norwood, Michael Aish. West Adelaide, R. Hamilton. Port Adelaide, R. Ebert. Port Adelaide, R. Ebert. West Adelaide, L. Watson. Glenelg, P. Brown. Norwood, G. Turbell. Glenelg, D. Rady. Central District, J. Platten. That completes the first 90 votes.
Thank you very much, Max. Let's now have a look at the voting in the overall top nine so far after the counting of 90 votes. We still see Michael Aish on top with 35, Weston 28, Mark Nady from South Adelaide comes up to 24, Gillies 21, two players on 20, Candelaftis and also Neil Craig of Sturt, Russell Ebert on 19, Ian Borchardt, the West Adelaide captain, polling 18, and Stephen Copping, the half-forward flanker from the Tigers, on 17. Let's now continue with the counting of the first preference votes. Back to you, Max.
Yes. South Adelaide, G. Aitken. South Adelaide, J. Schneebickler. North Adelaide, T. Clisby. West Adelaide, L. Watson. Central District, J. Platten. Norwood, G. Nicholson. West Torrens, T. Hill. North Adelaide, P. Cloak. Glenelg, P. Carey. Norwood, Michael Aish. North Adelaide, T. Clisby. Woodville, A. Matheson. South Adelaide, M. Naley. North Adelaide, G. McAdam. Central District, M. Wright. North Adelaide, D. Tiller. Sturt, N. Craig. Glenelg, Arsua, Glenelg, P. Weston, Norwood, G. Menzel, Glenelg, S. Copping, Central District, J. Platten, Central District, M. Wright, Sturt, N. Craig, North Adelaide, J. Riley, South Adelaide, M. Naley, North Adelaide, S. Curley, Sturt, T. Sims, West Adelaide, John Cantalaftis, South Adelaide, R. Hatley. And that concludes the first 120 votes.
You're viewing the McGarry Medal presentation through Channel 9 in Adelaide, relaying to RTS in Loxton and GTS Port Pirie. Let's now have a look at the exciting count as it stands at the moment. The overall top nine leaders: Michael Aish, 38, Paul Weston, 31, Naley, 30, very, very interesting now. Neil Craig, 26, Cantalaftis, 23, Jeff Gillies on 21, two players on 20, Stephen Copping from the Tigers and David Tiller from North Adelaide, and Russell Ebert on 19 from Port Adelaide. We'll come back with more in one moment's time. The 1981 McGarry Medal to the league's first, the most brilliant footballer in 1981. Back to you, Max.
Thank you, Ken. Central District, J. Platten. South Adelaide, R. White. West Torrens, D. Inglis. Woodville, L. Heaven. Norwood, G. Nicholson. West Torrens, I. Hanna. Port Adelaide, R. Ebert. North Adelaide, G. McAdam. North Adelaide, R. Robren. Glenelg, K. Coolman. West Adelaide, R. Hamilton. West Adelaide, G. Filkey. Mm-hmm. Port Adelaide, B. Cunningham. North Adelaide, G. McAdam. Port Adelaide, B. Cunningham. Glenelg, D. Marshall. West Adelaide, S. Reckner. Port Adelaide, R. Ebert. Port Adelaide, P. Belton. Sturt, N. Craig. South Adelaide, M. Naley. Port Adelaide, P. Belton. West Adelaide, Jeff Morris. Port Adelaide, S. Clifford. North Adelaide, Greg McAdam. Norwood, U. Colasanti. Norwood, U. Colasanti. West Adelaide, G. Morris. Central District, M. Wright. West Adelaide, S. Reckner. And that was vote 150 concluded, Ken.
Thank you very much, Max. Let's now have a look once again at the overall top nine so far as the voting is concerned at the moment. And no doubt the stage building up to what will be a very, very exciting finish. Michael Ace still on top with 38. Mark Nutty from South Adelaide polling very well with 33. Paul Weston, 31. Neil Craig on 29. Russell Ebert, 25. John Kentalaftis from West Adelaide, 23. Two players on 21. John Platten and Jeff Gillies and David Teller on 20. The leader at the moment is Michael Ace of the Norwood side. To continue the count, back to you, Max.
Thank you, Ken. North Adelaide, D. Tiller. Glenelg, Paul Weston. South Adelaide, P. Crate. South Adelaide, S. Palmer. South Adelaide, S. Palmer. Norwood, Keith Thomas. Glenelg, P. Carey. South Adelaide, G. Baines. South Adelaide, Mark Naley. South Adelaide, Ron Hatley. Norwood, D. Jenkins. Glenelg S. Copping. Port Adelaide R. Johnston. Port Adelaide R. Ebert. Central District J. Platten. West Torrens K. McSporran. Central District R. Van Dommel. Central District M. Wright. West Adelaide R. Bennett. West Adelaide R. Bennett. Sturt M. Graham. South Adelaide M. Naley. Port Adelaide R. Ebert. West Adelaide L. Watson. Sturt E. Fry. Central District, P. Graham. Norwood, Michael Aish. South Adelaide, G. Baines. Sturt, G. Wiseman. Glenelg, P. Weston. That concludes number 180th vote.
Thank you very much, Max. And one can feel the tensions now starting to mount. With only 30 votes to be counted in the 1981 McGarry Medal presentation, let's look at the overall top nine as it stands at the moment. Michael Aish with 41, still the leader. Mark Naley of South Adelaide on 39. Paul Weston of the Tigers, 37. Russell Ebert, 31. Neil Craig, 29. Platten, 24. And three players on 23. David Tiller, Stephen Copping and John Cantalaptis. We'll come back in one moment's time with more from the most exciting 1981 McGarry Medal presentation. Line Hotel, the 1981 McGarry Medal presentation continues with only 30 votes to be counted. One can feel the tension mounting. Back to you, Max.
Thank you, Ken. Sturt, K. Klomp. North Adelaide, D. Tiller. Sturt, E. Fry. Woodville, A. Matheson. Sturt, P. Heinrich. Sturt, P. Heinrich. West Adelaide, J. Faulting. Sturt, N. Craig. Glenelg, D. Marshall. Glenelg, P. Brown. North Adelaide, D. Tiller. West Torrens, I. Hanna. West Torrens, I. Hanna. Port Adelaide, B. Abernethy. West Torrens, T. Hill. I will now count the last 15 voting papers. South Adelaide, G. Brooksby. West Torrens, T. Hill. Sturt, C. Casey. Port Adelaide, R. Johnston. South Adelaide, P. Crate. North Adelaide, J. Riley. Norwood, D. Jenkins. Norwood, Michael Aish. North Adelaide, B. Loken. Glenelg, R. Sewer. Sturt, J. Derrington. Sturt, K. Klomp. North Adelaide, T. Clisby. Norwood, G. Turbull. And the last voting slip is North Adelaide, T. Clisby.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now my great pleasure to introduce to you the president of the South Australian National Football League, Mr. Max Bashir.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure that you'll all agree that Michael Aish possesses all of the qualities which are required of a McGarry medalist. It is my very great pleasure on behalf of the South Australian National Football League to congratulate Michael on his outstanding success. It's also my great pleasure to award him the McGarry Medal for 1981.
I was hoping Russ will give me a few pointers. There's plenty of people to thank, you know. Firstly, the boys out of the club, you know, what a magnificent bunch of blokes. Neil Baum for looking after me. My family, mum and dad, they've been absolutely tremendous. Andrew for giving me about his third kick this season last Saturday. And it's got to be a special mention. And I don't think I'd be standing up here unless it was the care that my sister's shown the last 9 months. A special thank you to her. And finally, I suppose I have to thank the umpires to give me a few votes. Thanks very much.
Michael, it's obviously been one heck of a week for you. How's the pressure been?
Oh, not too bad, Ken. We're just worrying about playing this Saturday.
You thanked a lot of people tonight, Michael. You mentioned Mum and Dad. They'll obviously be watching the telecast tonight. How would they be feeling, particularly Mum?
Mum would be distraught, I think. I don't know what Dad would be doing to calm her down, but they'd be thrilled, I think.
Michael, this has been your best year. Any particular reasons why?
Not getting injured, I suppose. It's been a good year. I'm just glad to get a run on the ball this year.
And what about your next ambition? You've won the McGarry Medal. What's your next ambition for Michael Aish?
To play at Norwood as long as I can and to win a premiership out there.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the 1981 McGarry Medal, Michael Aish. In a moment, we'll come back recapping the voting in the 1981 McGarry Medal. Michael Aish and his lovely sister Sue, embracing after, of course, that magnificent victory of Michael Aish in the 1981 McGarry Medal. Amazing scenes, really is. Right, let's now have a look at the voting, the top nine as it stood after the 1981 McGarry Medal presentation. There it is, Michael Aish the winner with 44, Mark Naley, a wonderful season for South Adelaide on 39, Paul Weston, the captain of the Tigers, 37, Neil Craig from Sturt, 32, Russell Ebert, Port Adelaide, polling 31, David Tiller of North Adelaide on 29, John Platten, the sensational young rover from the Dogs, 24, Stephen Copping from the Tigers on 23, and Johnny Candelafis having a tremendous season in the back pocket for West Adelaide on 23 also. The winner of the 1981 McGarry Medal was Michael Aish. We trust you've enjoyed our live telecast of the McGarry Medal. Thank you and good night.
Grabbed around the leg, but good umpiring lets it go on. Michael Aish! From behind it was Jenkins, Dillon for the crumbs. Oh, a beautiful tackle.
Here's a chance to Michael Aish. He's got plenty of time. Steadies in towards an open goal. We'll wait on the umpire. Up high goes Caldwell, no worries. Straight to the middle.
Teal the front. From behind Graham, no Aish. Geez, clever. Thump forward it further afield by the Eagles. Hannah loses it. Chance for Norwood now. Michael Aish! I can't believe it, and the Norwood supporters go berserk. A great goal, and who should do it better than Michael Aish, because he's won the game for Norwood.
Stick through thick and thin. There are days when you squawk about days when you can do without it. But today's the day, no, we're gonna win it.
You'll be Rocky, you'll be calm, you'll be Conzie.